Ice Ice Baby. Welcome back to Super Mario Bros. 3. I'm Duke of the Bum, and this is Ice World. We start out with yet another scrolling level. This one not as bad as the last couple, but I don't really like any scrolling levels. Man, even these blocks look kind of icy. How do they do that? It is a mystery. I guess I don't really have a problem with the scrolling levels, you know, fundamentally. It's just that I seem to die in them a lot more often than, you know, other levels. I have no idea if any of these other levels have, you know, secrets that occur when you get all the coins or not. It seems like it would make sense since, you know, that's a fairly difficult challenge to achieve. I don't know though. I never bothered trying. Huh. Water. That's weird. Why is it not frozen? The world may never know. And we're only 5 lives away from maxing out. It's pretty good for me. It's pretty early in the game to max out my lives. Oh, come on. Oh, come on, Jesus. Freaking slippery stuff. And we got another hammer. This is so exciting. I love reading unskippable text. Wonder how much longer it'll be until we're full up on stuff. Oops, I should have used a leaf first. Is it even possible to have a full inventory? I'm not sure. Oops, oh well. Oops, oh well. I wanted to go back and get that item. There we go. There we go. I can imitate that voice pretty well. That's the voice of Toad in Mario Party. When you get an item in one of the mini games, he comes out in this really annoying voice. He says, "Item." It's not as good as it usually is because I usually have to say it louder, but that's the gist of it. Oh no. I didn't get my 5 extra lives. I'm a sad panda. I don't know what this hammer that we got is good for. I guess we could have broke the rock next to that pipe and skipped this castle, but why would I do that? This castle is so much fun. In this castle, the very candles come to life to attack you. And we have these mysterious floating discs that I never did figure out what those are supposed to be. They're not fire. They're not really electricity. Oops. You can't kill them with invincibilities, but you can kill them with a tanuki suit. What the heck are they? They're just floating balls of generic energy. Wait a second. No. Oh. What the heck is up there? I don't think I've ever been up there. It's odd. You know what? I want to try getting up there. Screw it. There's a portion of the game that I've never experienced. By golly, I'm going to experience it. And I'll show off the P-Wings while I'm at it. As you can see, the P-Wings are just a power-up that give you a raccoon tail and allow you to fly indefinitely. Which is a cool word. Indefinitely. I probably could have gotten up there with just a regular raccoon tail, but, you know, why not? This is fun. What is up here? My lord. A 1-up? Is that it? Oh, you gotta be kidding me. And it even disappeared. I wasted P-Wings for a freaking 1-up. Oh well, at least I saw something to do. I learned something today. Haha, you can get me. Boom. You can, but I'm not gonna let you. Ooh, what now? What now? Oh, you're pissed off, aren't you? And P-Wings go away at the end of a level. Well, they turn into a regular raccoon tail, so... yeah, that was kind of a waste. But you know what? We have 1, 2, 3, 4... 4 more pairs. And we're definitely not going to need all of them. There's only 1 or 2 levels I can think of off the top of my head where the P-Wings are really a necessity. Oh, so close. And yet so far away. Interesting. And this level is really easy to lose your footing on because we have spinny platforms, we have slippery ice, and I just lost my footing. Go figure. Maybe I should See, this is what I'm talking about with the screen scrolling. You know, you see how it scrolls all at once instead of smoothly? Like how Legend of Zelda does? That's typical NES scrolling. Alright, should I equip a power-up first? I'll use one of these. Why not? Why not? It'll give me an extra hit point anyway. Like, kind of ironic that I died trying to get an extra life. Maybe I should try again. Alright, yeah, I'll just leave that alone from here on out. I won't use a power-up, it's not necessary. I should know better than to go off course like that. I should just stick to the script. Not that I have a script. Rest assured that if this was scripted, it would be a lot more interesting than this. Whoa. There's some arrangement of coins slash blocks up there. That was weird. Oh well. Oh, come on. There we go. So, how about them Yanks? They're a pretty respectable baseball team, or so I hear. And this is another one of those rare cases of an infinitely respawning power-up. You can come into this room over and over again, and there's either going to be a mushroom or a leaf there. And this can be a kind of a tricky level if you don't know what to do. It's all about flying up the correct passageway here. And this is the one, but as you can see, we can't get down there without some sort of help. Which means that I shouldn't have squandered that turtle. I should have saved it. I'm not sure if I need to leave and come back, or if there's another turtle here somewhere, or what. Yeah, I'm gonna have to make that turtle respawn. And the leaf is back. Alright, this time we want to make sure we don't kill the turtle. We just want to incapacitate it. Where is that turtle? Teenage Mutant Ninja Hamsters. Teenage Mutant Ninja Hamsters. Where the Christ is the freaking turtle? This is starting to piss me right off. Does it turn on? Oh, there he is. How did I? Well, I don't know. I am a dummy. But we need to. Oh, come on. Yeah, he leaves the screen if you go just, or he comes back if you leave the screen, so you don't want to do that. It's Adolescent Radioactive Samurai Slugs. I love that show. Alright, and that about does it for Let's Play Super Mario Bros. 3. Hope y'all tune in tomorrow for more Mario Madness.